Alright, so good evening. This evening I'm going to be talking specifically about rearranging our economy, our current economy, which thus far has been a direct quick push from manufacturing, and manufactured at a gluttony rate, at a gluttony consumption, at a gluttony available. We are going to change it. We are going to do it quick and easy. The quick and easy cure, and it is, yes, a cure, and it's fast, and it's called a 6% eco tax. A 6% eco tax immediately upon anything that has been manufactured. And I mean manufactured in factories, manufactured through machinery, manufactured through a set of humans that even a kit parted together. That is a manufactured product. Now, when we're looking at products that are handmade, they would not have that sign. They would not have that 6% tax. Thereby, that would already give a heads up to those that are working at home, especially in this time, those that are needing to create a product to sell. Okay? So those that create to sell would not be penalized like they have been in the past, or hidden dark away like you don't exist. This would be, hey, you guys are highlighted now. This is 2020. We are getting rid of the manufacturers. We are getting rid of that process of destruction. We are heading towards homemade products. I don't care what it is you make. If you make cups or sponges or whatever, you make them at home, you make pillows, great. You are the one rewarded. I don't want any more rewards coming from the manufactured cycle. Okay, we're looking right now at Amazon.com. 3,000 new sellers per day. Now, when I say new sellers, I mean those are people that are businesses that are selling products, that are selling manufactured products. Some are selling used products. We have to reward those ones that are selling used products. They are the ones that are our new trophies. They are our new people to shine out there. No longer is it going to be the past Barbie doll collection. I don't care if you make 1,000,000,000 Barbie dolls out of my little dancers that I've painted. Go ahead. But I think they should all be handmade. Don't you get it? Handmade. We have got to get rid of it. Because with getting rid of it, what happens to us? What happens to us, folks? We have something called quality versus quantity. Well, you can say the quality is better manufactured. We have quantity reduction immediately. Just by that 6% tax levied, we have quantity reduction. So when you go to the store, there it is. There's an aisle of items. They're all handmade. You are supporting directly the human beings, the economy, most likely near you, but they could be very great distance also. But you are supporting immediately that economy. You are not supporting a factory machine. You are not supporting a big, large corporation any longer. This is our fight, is to get rid of that big, large corporation group. That group that has pushed us and smashed us down into the earth so far that we are looking at our planet crippled. I really hate these economic statements because to me they are so obvious, but it has to be done, you know. The cure is an eco tax, 6% on any manufactured product. Okay, so yeah, we're looking at the big behemoth of 3,000 sellers right now that are looking at their lists of what they're going to sell online, how they're going to compete with China. Are they China? Yeah, they could be them also. Either way, You know, if you're going to be buying manufactured, you need to be controlled. All of those sellers need to be controlled. And they need to be controlled by a 6% tax on manufactured. That controls the population as well. Because the population has proved themselves to be so ignorant in purchase and ignorant in accepting reconsumeration and reconsumeration again and again, that we have no choice. Governments have no choice. Leadership has no choice but to tax them for their purchases. That is our only way to cool it here. And stop heating up this planet. That is our only way to cool down. Okay, yeah, I've definitely thrown it out there to Amazon lately, and I am a little tired of it. I have put quite a bit out there on my blog. I believe my last top 10 list is quite, it just gets to the point of what they have been trying to pull without any leadership at all going on in that company, just straight out bargaining of our planet down, bargaining our planet down into the dirt of nothing, as well as our economies as well, levying only up larger corporations. This is unbelievable. I don't mean levying. I guess, you know, levying is a weird word, isn't it, when you look at levying, because it really means levy, like you've lifted that boat, but they've turned it into taxation also, so it gets confusing. But yeah, levying up, yeah, that becomes a toughie for the brain rearrange. Okay, so anyway, so where was I at? 6% tax. And that really, you know, that the stupid consumer, the ignorant consumer in the shop is going, oh my gosh, okay, and I'm sitting here looking at this terrible product here because I'm painting, and it's acrylic, and it's definitely the wrong way to go. It has to be gotten out of our production cycle. We can't be selling this kind of crap any longer. We have got to change away from this. We can't be selling acrylic paint. We have got to get away. We have to go back to the caves of La Salle. We have to go back to that type of art. We have to make charcoal. We have to make cave paintings out of dried blood right there on the canvas. That is our direction. We cannot any longer. We can use eggs from a hen. We cannot use this type of crap. This is not a way forward. This product has to be taxed 6%. This product needs to be eliminated, period. It's all about the rearrange of the products that are on display. And we are looking at 3,000 sellers brand new each day. Signing on as subscribers to the behemoth Amazon. It's just unfathomable. Unfathomable. That amount of human beings becoming a new business without any kind of watchdog system, without any kind of, hey, you know, we're the Echo now. We don't do that any longer. This is not 1950s. We don't sell that sofa ever again. We don't do that any longer. All of this must be changed, must be rearranged to ensure a future. Otherwise, you can only accept a death. Which side are you on? Which side are you on? A future or a death? Make it patently clear to yourself every day. Which side are you on?